In the last couple of videos, I've defined the abstract concept of a vector space, and we talked about what does it mean for a set of vectors to be linearly independent. In this video, I want to define a few more terms that are widely used in the sciences and engineering when talking about vector spaces. So let's start with a set of vectors, V1, V2 through Vn. We say that these vectors span a vector space. Consisting of all linear combinations of V1 through Vn. Okay? So that if you're given a set of vectors, you can generate a vector space by just forming all linear combinations of that set of vectors. And then we say that the set of vectors span that vector space. So I can give you an example by giving you a set of vectors. So let's look at this set of vectors we considered in the last video. So we can have the set of vectors given by 1, 0, 0. 0, 1, 0, and the last one, 2, 3, 0. So these are three vectors. They're 3 by 1 column matrices. These three vectors span a vector space. So all linear combinations of these three vectors will span the vector space that has zero, the vector space actually consisting of 3 by 1 matrices that have zero in the third row, right? So this is the vector space. These span a vector space of 3 by 1 matrices with zero in the third row, right? And we say that that's also a vector subspace. So that's another definition. So this vector space is a vector subspace of all 3 by 1 matrices. Okay? So here I define span and I define the meaning of vector subspace. Okay. If you look at these three vectors, you would say, okay, we're spanning a vector subspace that has zero in the third row. But do we actually need all these three vectors? No, because in the last video I showed you the third vector is a linear combination of the first two, so that these three vectors are not linearly independent. They're linearly dependent. So in fact, we only need two of these vectors, and that's the definition of a basis. So a basis of a vector space is a set of minimum number of vectors that span the space. Okay? So that's the definition of a basis. For a vector space. So it's the smallest, so it's it's the vectors that can form a smallest set that can span the vector space. So here, the vector, the basis for the vector space consisting of 3x1 matrices with 0 in the third row. So as the example here, the basis could be the following. It could be just the first two vectors, right? That forms a basis for this vector subspace or this vector space. But we could have any of these two vectors. So it could be 1, 0, 0, 2, 3, 0. That can also generate all 3x1 vectors with a 0 in the third row. Or we can even have the other combination, 0, 1, 0, and 2, 3, 0. So these three sets of two vectors all form a legitimate basis for the vector space spanned by these three vectors. Okay? We'll see that we're going to actually prefer one of these sets. We're going to prefer the first one, if we have a choice between these three, because these vectors are orthonormal, and we're going to like orthonormal, right? So orthonormal means that, so let me put the word here. So these are orthonormal. So we say it's an orthonormal basis. It means that these two vectors are orthogonal. So 1, 0, 0 transpose 0, 1, 0 equals 0, right? That's the dot product. And they're normalized to 1. So we say that these two vectors are orthonormal. This is an orthonormal basis. There are other orthonormal bases, but this is the only orthonormal basis out of these three. All three of these are valid basis, though, for this vector space. Okay, so we've got span, we've got basis. The last one is dimension. So the dimension of a vector space is the number of basis vectors, okay? And that's unique. So the number of basis vectors required to span a vector space is called the dimension of the vector space. So here, the vector space of 3x1 matrices with 0 in the last row requires two vectors to form a basis for that vector space. So the dimension of that vector space is 2. So here, the dimension is 2. Okay? So let me summarize then these definitions. We say a set of vectors span a vector space consisting of all linear combinations of that set. So you can, given any set of vectors, you can form a vector space by forming all possible linear combinations of that set of vectors. But you can condense that more by forming a basis for a vector space. So a basis for a vector space is a set of vectors that are linearly independent that also span the vector space. So here in this example, I gave you three vectors that span the vector space of 3x1 matrices with 0 in the third row. But that is not a valid basis because one of these vectors depends on the other two vectors. A valid basis would be any two of these vectors. Any two of these vectors are linearly independent, and they also span the same vector space. The number of basis vectors defines the dimension of the vector space. Here, the dimension is 2. Okay, now we're going to use all of these concepts and start, and we will look at their application to matrices. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.